All right, I feel like this is a video I should have made a while ago, as maybe a lot of you guys who have been fans of the channel for a while have noticed that I really haven't been streaming in for, I would say, the past like 3 or 4 months. I really haven't done a single stream on this very channel, and I feel like I owe you guys an explanation for that, as that's one of the core foundations of what my channel's built on. So for me to just give up on streaming like that probably deserves a little bit of an explanation. Now, what this video, my entire goal with this is to kind of reconnect with you guys a little bit and figure out what my audience is saying, as I don't really get the interaction that I otherwise would from streaming if I'm just making videos. So this is probably a good way to get back at that, but not only just that fact, but also that this is probably going to be very relevant and useful information for any of you who are maybe considering wanting to be a YouTuber or a Twitch streamer. This is, I think, vital information for you to know. So to explain exactly why I stopped streaming, I need to give you a bit of background information on where my channel came from, what I wanted to do with it and everything like that, and what I did going forward, and so that you have a better understanding of why I made the choices that I made. So really quick, I'm going to take you back to the summer of 2017, and if you're a Call of Duty Zombies fan, this was a big time for that community. Zombies Chronicles had just released, and for the first time in a while, this was the full rise of YouTube streaming. And so back in summer of 2017, it's important to know that this was pre-Fortnite YouTube. So what this ended up meaning was that on YouTube Gaming, where all the streams were happening, Call of Duty Zombies was the number one streamed game pretty much every single day consistently. There was a lot of opportunity there because there was an unbelievable amount of attention on this game, and if you were streaming it daily and you had something to offer, odds are you were gonna get pretty big off of it. And myself and a couple of my other friends really ended up kind of making a name for themselves, not only just in the Zombies community, but just on YouTube in general because of this. And that's all well and great, right? I think growing from streams is a perfectly okay thing to do, but it does come with some problems, and we're gonna get into that later. But a couple months down the road, Zombies hit a rough patch. You guys already know this if you're part of the community, or if you know anything at all about what happened to Zombies, like I guess post IW and like around World War II and that sort of thing. Zombies really took a downfall, and that's an entire video on its own. I'm not gonna get into that as to why, but what you need to know is that a lot of creators, and myself included, were looking for other venues to pursue because Zombies just really wasn't cutting it for them creatively, financially, whatever. And they wanted to pursue other passions and other projects that they had been working on. So around this time, I started a second channel. And what also happened around that time was that I came across a little old game you might know called PUBG. And so at the time, my mindset was that, like, this is a game that I'm really enjoying, PUBG that is, and then I'm not really going to post anything just because it's something I can do in my spare time, and I don't know if people really want to watch it. And so I continued to post Zombies content, and it just, like I said earlier, was not really cutting it, and I wasn't enjoying myself making the content either. And so what I ended up doing was experimenting with a couple of PUBG videos. I had some friends encourage me to at least try it, and so I did. What ended up happening after a couple of months was that the PUBG content, just the videos that I were making, were far and away just outdoing everything Zombies that I was doing at the time. So whether that be a stream or a video that I had been working on, just did not hold a candle. And so the choice was pretty clear. I could either pursue a game that I really enjoyed and that was doing well for me, or I could continue on a game that I wasn't really enjoying too much and content that wasn't performing well. So the choice was very clear. Eventually, I guess what happened is just I slowly stopped posting more and more Zombies and more Battlegrounds until I became a full-time Battlegrounds YouTuber, I guess you could say. And I would say I had one of the smoothest transitions when it comes to major content. A lot of my friends switched to Fortnite, and they caught an absolute ton of flack for it, and a lot of it was just not well-deserved. And so I'm fortunate to be in the position where I didn't really get any backlash for switching, and I think it was primarily because it wasn't Fortnite, and I think people were just projecting when the game was getting popular and their distaste for the game. There's still a little bit of that around, but it's really calmed down over the past year, I would say. And so I had a second channel made, and originally that was going to be for anything that wasn't Zombies that I wanted to post, and Battlegrounds included. And so what happened was when I just started going full-time PUBG on my main channel, I left the second one in the dust. Now, I didn't want to stop streaming entirely on my main channel, and so what I started doing was streaming Battlegrounds and then also maybe a mix of Zombies every now and again. And what I noticed from this was that the streams, after I would do them for, I would say, maybe around a week, I would notice that the video performance would plummet. All my videos would stop being recommended. The views were just, like, cut in half, essentially. And the streams would cause my video performance to go way down. And so I know this is going to sound a little bit dramatic, but if I had continued on the same path that I had when I started streaming PUBG on the main channel, it easily would have killed my channel, I'd say within like 3 or 4 months. Now, some of this is going to get like a little bit like YouTube technical. So if you're not really concerned about this stuff, then it doesn't really matter. But I'm going to explain the reason I think why this is going on. And it's not just me. So the idea right now is that YouTubers who also post videos and live stream have to ride this really fine line about how they do it. Apparently, from what I've been able to gather from my channel, and I've studied literally hundreds of other channels who do this as well, is that if you want to be a content creator who posts videos and streams, it's not possible on YouTube, because what happens, there's something on YouTube called a CTR, it's a click-through rate, and basically what that means is every time somebody either on their homepage or in their subbox sees your video, and if they click on it, that will make your click-through rate go up. If they scroll by and they don't click on it goes down a little bit. And obviously, the higher your click-through rate, then the better your channel is going to do overall, the more people you're reaching. So you want to keep that click-through rate as high as possible. And so what live streaming does, if you're also posting videos, is say you do a live stream and you let it become a VOD, and most people, I would say 99% of people, will not click on a stream, on YouTube that is, a stream VOD after it is done being live. And so what that means is that it makes your click-through rate just absolutely plummet. Like, I think it destroys any momentum that you have, regardless of how your videos are doing or what you're uploading or what you're streaming for that matter. It really doesn't matter at the end of the day. As long as that click-through rate keeps going down, you're kind of in trouble. And I tried this 3 separate times on my channel, like a full experiment. I would study, I would do some streams, and then I would make sure I would watch my video performance over the next couple weeks. Without fail, every single time after I got done from like a streaming sesh for about a week or so, my video performance would just fall through the floor. And then when I would stop streaming for a couple of weeks and I would just keep uploading videos, like the views would start to climb back up and things would resurface back to normal. I thought that's really weird. So I decided to study other channels that are doing the same thing. And unfortunately, what happens is I've watched channels literally run themselves into the ground just by streaming. And unfortunately, like I said, I've just seen channels completely die because they tried to do streams and upload, and then that makes the videos do poorer, and then it makes their streams do poorer. And it's like this backwards, it's this reverse feedback loop that is unbelievably unhealthy for your channel. And so I'm glad I realized that when I did and I stopped streaming. Now, the other big factor that I think is a big part of this is that, as far as I can tell on YouTube, it really seems that people who subscribe for live streams, for the most part, only want to watch live streams. And so what that means is that you gain a subscriber because you're streaming. That subscriber is likely only to come back for when you're streaming again. So if you happen to upload a video, that subscriber, from what I can tell, from what the numbers say, is very unlikely to return and watch your video. Now, I will say this though, there are still some channels that kill it from streaming. And what you notice is that most of them are either just full stream channels or they upload videos too. Now, it's important to know that not every single YouTube channel dies from streaming. Like, that's not what I'm suggesting. It's more the fact that channels that only stream can really get away with it, and they can actually grow quite a bit from it because they, number one, have a full-built streaming audience, and their click-through rate doesn't fluctuate at all, and I think that doesn't, like, trigger the YouTube algorithm in any way. And so I think a lot of those channels that are much bigger and that stream all the time can get away with it, and it's okay, and even they can upload videos, and they're so big that they're going to do moderately well regardless. But for smaller channels, this is, like, a very dangerous game to play, and so you really have to go, in my opinion, either one of two ways. You got to be a full, like, YouTube streamer and really not worry about making videos, or you gotta be just upload videos. And now here comes my dilemma, because I don't consider myself a streamer. I consider myself as a content creator that likes to stream, that also streams. And so I need to find a way for me to do both. The problem is videos are great because they're very creatively satisfying, and you can like make whatever you like and package it really nicely and deliver it to your audience. Like, the care that you put into it really shows, and I like that aspect of it. But what you get with streaming is that you get this kind of one-to-one interaction that you would never ever get with videos. But the problem with streams is that they're not very creatively satisfying. It's literally just, for the most part, you sitting there either playing the game or just talking to chat. And there's nothing wrong with that, but it isn't very creatively satisfying. And so what I'm trying to do for me is find the best balance of doing both. So I made my point kind of clear that YouTube streaming is detrimental in most cases. Even regardless of what YouTube would tell you or what it says on the homepage, it really doesn't matter, as the things that I've studied and the people that I've talked to all the numbers show that the complete opposite is true. Streaming is very, very bad for your channel. I'm going to continue to keep doing research on this because it's very, like, important to me. But for right now, this is the conclusion that I've come to. Okay, so I've made the case that YouTube streaming is not very good, especially if you want to upload videos, and that's fine. And so the question now that you might be asking, okay, well, why don't you just move to Twitch, or why don't you go to Mixer or DLive, or just literally whatever other site and stream there. I thought about that for a while, and the conclusion that I came to was that I don't think it's that simple. For me anyways, the problem that I run into is that if you want to be as successful as I'd like to be on Twitch, that you really got to be a streamer. Like, you have to do that full time, and unfortunately that takes away time from being able to make videos, which as I said earlier, is very important to me. So if I'm going to go to Twitch, like, I'm going to want to send it. I would basically, I guess, stop making the videos that I am right now currently, and then if I were to still make content, they would just be like highlights from the stream. And that's, right now, I guess it's still in the cards per se, but it's not something that I really want to do. Not just that, but another big problem that I ran into with Twitch is, or just any other streaming site, I'm just using Twitch as it's the best example, but another problem that I ran into is that I've spent the last couple of years building my audience here on YouTube, and that's primarily where everybody knows me from. And I don't want to split my audience and go to Twitch and confuse viewers on where they should watch, because this is something to think about as well. If you're a streamer, the viewers that watch you are not only there to interact with you, that's a big part of it. They want to watch you play a game, they want to talk to you and everything that comes with live streaming, but they also want to interact with each other. And I think that's a very important part of having a healthy stream. And the problem if I move to Twitch is that a lot of my viewers only want to watch streams on YouTube. Like, you'd be surprised, the majority only want to watch on YouTube, and that's fine. Like, everybody enjoys what platform they enjoy. And so that is precisely why I think that streaming on YouTube and Twitch at the same time is a very bad idea, because you confuse viewers on where you want them to watch, and maybe say one friend wants to watch you on YouTube and his friend wants to watch you on Twitch. They don't get to interact with each other in the same chat, and that's where half the fun is with live streaming. So for me right now, Twitch, the way that I would want to do it, I wouldn't be able to make the proper sacrifice about the content that I'm making on YouTube right now and then also do Twitch. So it's not something that's completely out of the cards. I'm still considering it, but it right now it's not something I think I'm gonna do. So the solution that I've been able to come with right now is that I'm going to keep my concentrated YouTube audience on YouTube, and we're going to use the second channel that I made a while ago for streaming. This way I don't split anybody up. This way I get to keep sort of the culture that I had originally when I was streaming on this channel back in the zombies days. And the fact that this channel and my second one are very closely related, so most of my audience here should probably know about the second one too, which is what you want. And also what's good about the second channel is that I can stream literally whatever I want to. There's no pressure for me to only do Battlegrounds or to only do a certain game. I can stream whatever I like. And the freedom of that is very important to me as well. So basically, I guess this is a roundabout way of saying that if you're a Zombies fan from the old days and you've missed a lot of the live streams, I would highly recommend that you are subscribed to the second channel. And even if you're a Battlegrounds fan that found me through PUBG stuff, either you found me through the PUBG streams or just the videos themselves, but you want to see the streams and see what they're all about, check the description down below and go subscribe to that second channel, guys. But all in all, I physically cannot stream on my main channel on YouTube in fear that it literally will kill my channel. And until something gets done about this, I literally don't think I can ever stream on YouTube on this channel again. I just don't think it's possible. I'm going to do what I can to keep, like, researching this and hopefully YouTube gets whatever they have going on sorted out. And again, it's only half fixed because, as I said earlier, I really believe a large portion of people that subscribe for streams only want to watch streams. The videos that are already posting on this channel, if you're a fan of them, then don't worry. They're not going anywhere. They're going to stay coming out as they are. But if you're a fan of the live streams and maybe you haven't watched in a while, you're back from the zombies days, and I really think that there's a large portion of my audience who falls under that category who just hasn't watched in a bit, I really recommend that you go over to the second channel where I'm going to be streaming some zombies. I'm going to be streaming other stuff, and it's a great place to go and interact with me. But yeah, it's been a learning process. It's been definitely a long time coming now that I had to figure out exactly the balance between why I couldn't stream and where exactly I should stream. And what this allows me to do is fulfill both things that I would like to, which is the interaction with streams and then also the creative fulfillment with videos. I can do both of those. And right now, this is the prime solution. Like I said, Twitch in the future, I'm not leaving that out of the equation, but right now it's just not in the cards. Right now, the second channel from here on out is where streams are gonna be. But yeah, I really feel like I needed to make this video and explain to you guys exactly why I haven't been streaming, as I feel bad about it, but I wasn't able to convince convey exactly what I wanted to convey without doing this. So what I want to know from you guys in the comments is, you watching this video right now, what did you subscribe for? How did you find my channel? What did you sub from? Was it a stream? Was it from zombies? Was it from a PUBG video or a stream? Like literally however you found me, I would like to know, because I want to get a little bit more of a, I want to reestablish the closer connection that I had with my audience when I was purely live streaming, and I want to get that back a little bit. So let me know how you found me, and let me know what made you stick around, because I think that's equally important. I want to know the things that you enjoyed on here so I can do them more. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys very much for watching. I hope this explanation did make sense. And at the end of the day, the message that I want to get across is that if you're a fan of the streams, and if you've not seen any streams and you would like to, check the description. My second channel will be linked down there. Make sure you're subscribed, as I will be streaming there pretty often. And if you're watching this on the day that it's uploaded, I'll be streaming over there tonight. So you can literally watch this video. Go check out the stream as soon as you're done watching. But yeah, anyways, I really appreciate you guys for watching. And I really greatly appreciate all the support that you've shown on both channels recently. It's been amazing. And I think we're going to keep that up as best we can. So thank you guys so much. But yeah, go check out that second channel in the description, and make sure you're sub there for live streams. But I'll see you guys over there either on the next video on here or the next stream over there. Thank you guys for watching, and peace out.